Greetings. Please be patient. This video is not Trump-focused or America-focused. It is about real-world prophetic events. As such, it is ultimately Israel-focused, Zion-focused, and Jerusalem-focused. I completely appreciate Bible teachers who endeavor to keep up with Bible prophecy. Prophecy is critical to having an understanding and awareness of God's plan in action. While I followed the Tetrad closely, and the eclipse, and then the September 23rd sign, I was always torn regarding any dates they implied or hinted toward. Have you noticed how all the date setting has died down? But recently I've been mulling over the book of Daniel. My fascination was seeded after watching a movie titled The Book of Daniel. You can actually find the entire movie in low def on YouTube. Please watch it and then buy it somewhere at full price, just not Amazon. The story and message feels respectfully handled, even if it may lack Spielbergian polish and CGI effects. So why am I doing a movie review in the middle of a video about Donald Trump? The Book of Daniel documents four kings that Daniel the prophet lived under. The last king was named Cyrus, and his reference is Cyrus the Great. And this is the part that blew me away. Prophet Isaiah actually named Cyrus by name in a prophecy about 150 years before Cyrus came to power. Isaiah 45:1. Thus says the Lord to Cyrus his anointed, whom I have taken by his right hand, to subdue nations before him and to loose the loins of kings, to open doors before him so that gates will not be shut. I will go before you and make the rough places smooth. I will shatter the doors of bronze and cut through their iron bars. God's going to make this king victorious. I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden wealth of secret places, so that you may know that it is I, Yahweh, the Lord, the God of Israel, who calls you by your name. Who calls you by your name. For the sake of Jacob, my servant, and Israel, my chosen one, I have also called you by your name. I have given you a title of honor, though you have not known me. Called you by your name. I am Yahweh, the Lord, and there is no other. Besides me, there is no God. I will gird you, though you have not known me, that men may know from the rising to the setting of the sun that there is no one besides me. I am Yahweh the Lord, and there is no other. The one forming light and creating darkness, causing well-being and creating calamity. I am Yahweh the Lord, who does all these. Prophet Daniel, being a scholar of the scriptures, the prophets, knew of Isaiah's prophecy. Prophet Daniel also knew of the foretold 70 years of exile from the land of Israel. Jeremiah 29:10. For thus says the Lord, when 70 years have been completed for Babylon, I will visit you and fulfill my good word to you to bring you back to this place. Chapter 29 of Jeremiah, as a whole, is a letter written by Jeremiah as the captivity was beginning. Now these are the words of the letter from Jeremiah the prophet sent from Jerusalem to the rest of the elders of the exile, the priests and prophets and all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had taken into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. Prophet Isaiah, Prophet Jeremiah, and Prophet Daniel, all involved in a divine event God inspired, created. And we have the original detailed accounts of the events, Isaiah's prophecy, Jeremiah's letter, and Daniel's life in Babylon. If you are Christian, think on facts like these when a Muslim accuses corruption of the Bible. Tell a Muslim this story of three prophets and ask, what has been corrupted? So I have been percolating on the book of Daniel and the prophecy of prophet Isaiah. King Cyrus the Great was named by God over 100 years before Cyrus was born. That would not be very impressive if every king of Babylon were named Cyrus the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, and so on. Just leave off the number and there will be a King Cyrus to fit one day. And no doubt those who disregard God and the evidence God exists would choose such an approach. But here is the kicker. Babylon did not have a history of kings named Cyrus. Or just have the prophet write prophecies for King Carl, Charlie, Chuck, Clarence, Clyde, Cliff, Cyril, Saipan, Cyrus, Dan, Daniel, David, Doug. Wait for the name that pops up and just pull out the scroll of 10,000s with it and name the current dude in power. And hope he has no recall of the last three kings you tried this shtick on. Again, a schemer would think such a deception an easy and believable explanation, rather than Yahweh God naming Cyrus 100 years in advance. And here is the kicker. There are not any other scrolls, not a single one, naming other than Cyrus. In fact, the Jewish captivity happened during transitions and was where other nations conquered Babylon. That's about like throwing the dice and then having someone fast change dice on the table before they bounce to a stop. God said when, and God said who, and God said it in advance, where no man had the ability to fake it. So Cyrus was informed by Daniel of the prophecy of Isaiah, and Cyrus let the Jewish people return to Jerusalem. Return to Jerusalem, the city of David, the city of God, where the temple was restored and rebuilt. The temple that Islam to this day tries to deny ever existed. You can hear the chief Palestinian liar make such denials and claims at the UN every speech. Pray for Muslims who obey and worship Muhammad above Yahweh God who called Cyrus by name. Imagine my ears perk up when Prime Minister Netanyahu visited President Trump recently. The following is extracted from CBS News under fair use for educational purposes. You can actually trust it because no commentator from CBS says a single word in the video clip.
And Mr. Prime Minister, Mrs. Netanyahu, it's a great honor to have you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Donald, Melania, Sarah and I want to thank you for your extraordinary friendship and hospitality. It's always a pleasure to see you both, but this is the first time we meet in Washington, America's capital, after you declared, Mr. President, Jerusalem as Israel's capital. And this was a historic proclamation, followed by your bold decision to move the embassy by our upcoming National Independence Day. I want to tell you that the Jewish people have a long memory. So we remember the proclamation of the great king, Cyrus the Great, Persian king, 2,500 years ago. He proclaimed that the Jewish exiles in Babylon can come back and rebuild our temple in Jerusalem. We remember 100 years ago, Lord Balfour, who issued the Balfour Proclamation that recognized the rights of the Jewish people in our ancestral homeland. We remember 70 years ago, President Harry S. Truman was the first leader to recognize the Jewish state. And we remember how a few weeks ago, President Donald J. Trump recognized Jerusalem as Israel's capital. Mr. President, this will be remembered by our people throughout the ages.
Prime Minister Netanyahu mentions Cyrus and says the Jewish people have a long memory. It helps when the God who created heaven and earth has recorded the history that matters. So what has this to do with President Donald Trump? If you have been asleep, let me recap for you. It was impossible for Donald Trump to win election. Donald Trump had no real political party support. Donald Trump's declared party even split into a bitter group called Never Trumpers. The Democrat Party colluded and conspired to eliminate Bernie the Commie as a candidate. The Democrats gave Hillary the debate questions in advance to prep her. They had to, because she is too stupid to handle two email accounts. The Democrats controlled every news story from the leftist press whores. The FBI, in the pocket of Obama and the Democrats, allowed blowjob Bill to conspire on the tarmac with the so-called Department of Justice leader to squash the investigation into the Clinton criminal enterprise. The American media fix was in. They would lie to protect Hillary and lie to attack Donald Trump, which they continue to this day. But as I've said before, this whole prophecy thing ain't no stopping it. Almighty God sets up governments, and he tears them down. But why would it even matter to God to have President Trump in office? Because only one city on earth matters to God's world plan. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, say it with me, Jerusalem. Donald Trump has bravely done something of eternal prophetic consequence. Recognized God's eternal capital of Israel. Before this, I do not think it was the right time in the prophetic calendar. But on May 14, 1948, the nation of Israel was reborn into the earth. Isaiah 66:8. Who has ever seen anything as strange as this? Who ever heard of such a thing? Has a nation ever been born in a single day? Has a country ever come forth in a mere moment? But by the time Jerusalem's birth pains begin, her children will be born. Ezekiel 37:11. Then he said to me, Son of man, these bones are the people of Israel. They say our bones are dried up and our hope is gone. We are cut off. Therefore prophesy and say to them, This is what the sovereign Lord, Yahweh, says. My people, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from them. I will bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you, my people, will know that I am Yahweh, the Lord, when I open your graves and bring you up from them. I will put my spirit in you, and you will live, and I will settle you in your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I have done it, declares Yahweh, the Lord. Just as the forces of Satan have been against the Jewish people and the nation of Israel, so too every evil in America has been against President Donald Trump. If President Donald Trump walked on the water in his bare feet, CNN fake news liars would report, Trump mocks people without shoes. Yahweh the Lord has a plan which no power in heaven or earth can stop. And he has been good and kind enough to lay out his plan in his word, the Bible. Jerusalem is the city of God on the earth. And that is why Satan's religion tries to make false claims on it. Jerusalem is mentioned 767 times in the Bible. Jerusalem is not mentioned once in Muhammad's Quran. Not one time. Islam has no claim to Jerusalem. Their only motive is Satan's motive, to steal it from the hated Jews that Yahweh promised and made covenant with. But more than simple numerical count, the fact of Jerusalem's future were foretold by God. And the restoration of the temple, which will happen soon, was implied and directly foretold. And President Trump has taken a huge, huge step toward prophetic fulfillment, recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital. This will be a forcing function that causes Satan chaos and a panic to launch his own plans. It is not because Donald Trump wrote the art of the deal, but President Trump's actions will be seen as a threat to Satan's agenda, and therefore a trigger to act. Keep your eyes on Jerusalem and on Israel, and on the enemies around them as they conspire against Israel. And look up, because time is short and your redemption draws nearer each day. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.